everyone's safe. And enjoy the show.
Thank you. I'm just finding this really upsetting now.
Oh, come on. It's your induction next.
My what?
Your induction. You'll feel better after that. Really, it's very wonderful here. Just a bit confusing at first.
I was on my bike.
Where are you?
I was going to join the picnic guy.
Come on.
At an Amazon fulfillment centre, I think I hit a tree.
I know.
You did?
Of course. What sort of conditioner did you say you used?
I didn't.
Are you from the no-conditioner school of hair washing? Brave. Maybe it's all too brave. It's very dry. Have you ever thought of using argan?
No, what's that?
It's for dry hair. The hospitality tea in heaven is always excellent, though they're usually crisp. But these are delicious. Hamburger. Cheese. Not hungry?
There wasn't a vegan option.
Cheese!
Cheese isn't vegan.
It is in heaven. Everything is vegan in heaven. I love cheese.
Who's that?
Hoffnail. He's a...
So bad!
What's that?
I was on my bike.
Trip up. You see how it is?
Excellent.
Is this a trick?
Awesome.
Did someone put you up to it? It's our new union rep, isn't it? She looks like a joker.
Sure.
I knew it. Okay, where is she? The game's not very funny. You can come out now.
Sure thing, yeah. Down the bridge.
Down where?
Viva the revolutionary!
What?
Excellent.
Pounding what?
You're trocking.
Trocking? Fan?
Sure thing.
Yeah. Why do all angels talk like this?
Picked up from the kids, didn't I?
I can tell.
It doesn't sound patronising.
Cool. Loud, little man.
Woman.
Whatever.
I am both.
It's not quite safe, man.
You need to relax.
Yeah, relax.
I am relaxed.
So, let's suppose if this is heaven.
The peak.
The peak. Why am I here?
Because you're trucking well, sick.
If this isn't a trick.
Be some trick, bro. I mean, we've got everything here. Magazines, conditioner, the wax stuff to put in your ears, pull the hairs out with. Eargasm.
Oh yeah! Eargasm!
You, my family, have got all your deities with other Roman sisters. When they were out, you were in.
Well in.
Marching with other Roman sisters. You stopped by, dug them out, went on the line, stared down the horses, fought the good fight. It was you. You took off the boys and girls, didn't it? That is why you got to
be. What Hoffnail means to say is that you worked your life for the benefit of others. You put everyone else before yourself. That's why you're here.
But I have no faith. I don't believe.
You do believe?
There is no
God. Yeah, we're going to be perfect to get a looking on the feet.
But you have to have faith.
Yeah, you do, bro. You do.
In what?
Marxism.
That's not a belief system.
Yeah, bro.
Wow.
Yep.
Banging.
Yeah, banging.
Banging.
Was that a smartphone? Doesn't he know how they're made?
They know most things up here.
The assembly lines.
Most things.
12-hour shifts, timed bathroom visits, no unionisation, bullying and shouting by the bosses, and workers driven to suicide.
Yeah. Sounds awesome!
Awesome?
Not awesome.
No, not awesome. In 2016, a group of just under 100 men and women threatened to commit a mass suicide in a Foxconn factory in China. Can you imagine the working conditions that drive 100 people to do that? They went to the top of a building and threatened to jump off.
Yeah, it doesn't matter here.
What?
I said it doesn't matter.
Your angel is using a smartphone.
Do you think a good haircut with some high quality conditioner would help? I do a great head massage.
A head massage?
Look at these fingers.
What? I am talking about an industry that is diabolical, literally, and yet this technology is being used in heaven or wherever we are.
Have a sandwich. I really think a sandwich would help.
Those are cheese sandwiches, like I said. And vegan, is that cheese even organic? Free range?
Well, no, because
milk production. Do you know about milk production?
Have you tried hair
machines milk twice a day, often developing mastitis. You should look at the pictures online. They live for as little as 5 years until their milk yield drops. Lifespan normally 20 until their crippled boys are sold for dog food. Let us know what happens to their calves. Do you know what happens to their calves, Bob?
No.
Within a day of them being born, they're torn away from their mums. Have you heard of a distressed cow pulling for its calf? Well, have you?
No. Or the hairdresser training you from Slough. There aren't any cows in Slough.
It's a sound that never leaves you. Once they're torn away from their mum, they're shoved and cramped into boxes and turned into veal after a short life of unimaginable suffering.
That sounds, well...
bad?
Bad.
Pretty diabolical again, I'd say. And we're supposed to be in heaven.
The peak.
The peak. I would have thought all crimes against humanity and animals would be, well, at least off limits. That's where your cheese is from, Bob. Eat up.
Well, it's just...
what?
Well, nothing is real here. It's like everything is imagined, so there is no farm, organic or otherwise. You can just have whatever you want, whenever you want it. You see, it's heaven, the peak. Abundance and all, lots of lovely things and Kentucky Fried Chicken whenever you want it. I love a good bit of Kentucky. Heaven wouldn't be heaven unless you have whatever you wanted. I mean, you wouldn't want all that austerity stuff in heaven now, would you?
A capitalist heaven. Who makes the rules?
That would be the great angelic order! The hierarchy, the rule, the authority.
So it's the hierarchy, of course.
Yeah, there's, like I said, different tiers. I mean, it's great because one day I'll make an angel. I'm at the bottom now, but I can see myself as a cherubim, can't you?
Not really.
Why? Do you think my cheeks need to be fatter? Look, see it now?
Am I about that one we just spoke to?
What? Hoffman?
Yeah.
He's a lower one.
He didn't look like an angel.
No, they only dress up for big occasions. It's the wings. They get in the way. Anyway, it's nice to have all the stuff you want whenever you want it. Ooh, I remember once my mum brought me this lamp and it was sick because when it blew it, it came on all by itself. It was dead amazing. Are you sure you don't want to buy it?
No, I don't want a sandwich. Mm. Get nothing out of my face.
What is that? It's not!
So the lower ones like you, they don't get to speak to him either.
near a woman's count against me.
So not only are the angels better than us, you're better than each other. There's a chain of command and a chain of betterness. You do know that I'm a Marxist.
I thought we didn't let Marxists in.
No, we do, Pa. We do. Valerie!
Can we bow? I suppose so.
I'll go for a bow, stare down the waters, put the fight, took on the boys and girls, isn't it?
They're trocking.
I looked at stats. All there. That's what I wanted to think.
Does he know about it?
He?
She?
He or she?
I saw Nanny around the who's wealthy and chatting about Cindy.
So, this chain of command.
We don't really look at it that way.
What other way of thinking than it is there?
Yes, River?
We're all messy in heaven.
Messy?
There's only one messy.
We don't know yet.
It all depends on how wealthy
No, River, this is heaven.
The peak.
Thank you.
The peak. Surely heaven should be perfect.
Yes, I am.
And then what?
Neymar.
Then I'll go to heaven. The peak!
I don't know.
But if you play really well.
Getting into heaven is to do with being good, not to do with sporting achievements. Anyone else? Anyone else? Yes.
How can I get to speak to God?
You can't. So today in this meeting room session, I'd like you to look around the room, spot something that you don't know, go up and introduce yourself and tell them something about yourself. Oldies, maybe take the initiative to go up and speak to the newbies. You just go up. No need to be afraid. This is heaven.
On the mugs.
What?
The big guy on
one before that. Discourse has always been and always will be.
Yeah, that's what the people say. It's just the way things are. See, no one's ever questioned it because it's always been so. Just don't think I can listen to it anymore.
Come on, we're leaving. You're being fast-tracked.
You can't! How can you not like the music, though?
I never have. I just didn't think this would change it. But now Valerie has said, can I call you about it?
Of course. Come on! You have to go with Nadia.
Why?
Well, because
you're ruining your chances of becoming an angel if you don't.
Hoof Neil!
What? I'm an angel. You speak truth, bro. Heaven, it can't be heaven unless we're all happy. Can it, Val? And we shall be happy if this is the peak.
Yeah, you should.
You hear that? We should all be happy.
And I never liked the music either. I thought I was the only one.
Me too. What about some progressive rock? It's always been disco.
I don't really have to get to listen to ELO.
Toto, what about some Toto?
Hold the line. Why can't we listen to Hold the
Line? It's always been disco!
Yeah, it's always been.
Well, we have no power and no say.
I thought we were leaving.
It's a bad choice whenever it
was made. It's a bad choice whenever it was made. It should be a consensus.
We had to replace the singing with something.
Right.
To keep the world in motion.
And I hate the bowing.
Me too.
It's oppressive.
Oh, I didn't start the bowing.
Well, who did?
I don't know. Someone above me. Yes, Shade?
I think I agree.
Aren't you happy?
Yes, heaven's very nice.
The peak.
The people are great. I mean, really friendly and kind.
You just
That's heaven for you.
Heaven's nice, but it would be nice to make it really nice. We've never consulted. The music's just part of it. I agree with Barry. There should be consensus, and what we decide should be acted on.
Otherwise, it's just a dictatorship.
Exactly.
Yeah, this band can do perfect. You'd expect some Toto.
Or at least some ELO.
And I'd like to meet God too.
Yeah, and God.
Yeah, and God. We'd all like to meet God.
This is your fault.
I really hate disco.
I don't choose the music.
Well, who does?
I don't know, someone above me.
Part of the hierarchy, the authority.
Yeah, part of the authority.
I thought you were leaving.
Yes, so did I. Yes, River?
What will happen again, Heaven?
I don't know. You can't get into heaven because of God, Average.
Of course you can.
Yeah, of course.
You know, I think I'm going to stay for a bit.
Toe, 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 toe
So they went to Earth.
But not all of them. No, we managed to keep all of the basses, sopranos, and tenors to kill the sound of orchids.
Those pet things?
Yeah, well, by then, the angels, we, couldn't imagine nothing. So there was like this wait between the people arriving at the beat and actually being able to imagine new technology because we'd lived with it and the angels acting as in the hands of it.
So the demands outstrip the supply?
Yeah, something like that. So those are just too impatient to wait and decided to go and get the sound of orchids themselves. That was where it ended. Then the basses went for the smartphones, and finally we lost the sopranos for the purple. And that is when we came from getting the old suited art to keep it up in the ocean.
I see.
Do they get to come back?
Shouldn't think so. My family got terrible memories. None of them, like, will remember who they were by now.
And what if we were to stop dancing?
Well, we'd stop. Everything would just stop.
When do you think I'll let you know? If I can talk to God?
The bosses never listen that long.
They can be made to listen to me.
No, they can't. I miss smartphones, fastening chipboards, one every minute.
Oh, that is good.
Oh, I was shouted at for not being fast enough. The factories of dorms that we rented. They're expensive and cramped. As many as 12 in one room. I couldn't sleep. They were hot and always noisy. As I got more tired, I got slower. And I fell behind. So the bosses shouted at me in front of everyone on the line. But I couldn't leave, because I was in debt to them, because of the rent for the dorms. I tried standing up for myself, but they called the police, who beat me up with sticks, and still, I fell behind. So they made me read out a letter in front of everyone on the line, promising that I'll never fall behind again. I couldn't take it anymore. I couldn't see any way out. So I went to the top of the dorm block and jumped. There are nets there now to stop people from killing themselves. It costs $5 to make a phone and they sell it for hundreds.
You're not moving your hands right, allow me! I charged a lot for these, you know, back in the south.
You still hear them?
Looks like it.
You ruined my chances.
For what?
For the wrong name, you
know. They're not like completely ruinable.
How did you get in?
His head massage is wicked. I was great with the customers.
People that paid you.
You don't know anything about heads, do you?
Never really thought about them.
Listen, we made literally hundreds of unloved men and women feel and look fantastic. A high quality conditioner, a good haircut, and a bit of chat is all most people need in the world. There are loads of hairdressers in heaven.
I love cutting the wave.
And what about your cost, Bob? How much did they make from the happiness you gave? From your labour?
Dunno, it was a good job. Everyone there was happy.
Everyone?
Well, apart from Jess.
Who was Jess?
She tried to unionise us.
If you tried to unionise at my factory, you would be beaten up and dismissed.
Why did she try to do that, Bob?
I don't know, I think she wanted a toaster.
It would have been the working conditions.
I got the minimum wage and no tips on top.
Where did your boss get the money from to start up the shop?
I think he said his dad was a postal worker and he just remortgaged his house.
Due to rates agreed by unions. Would you have been able to afford a house from your wages?
No.
Imagine if you could. Imagine if you all went on strike and maybe you could have been able to afford a house. Were there any other investors in your hairdressers?
Well, there was this Torah. I think she put some money in.
And she didn't work there, but took the profit, yes?
Doing nothing.
Where does she get her money from?
I think she lived in some mansion in Berkshire.
So, maybe slavery?
No, Torah was lovely!
If she comes from old money, then very likely. Do you know they were compensated?
The slaves? Well, yeah. You'd hope so.
The slaves when the Anti-Slavery Act came in. Millions of pounds setting themselves up for generations. It's inherited wealth that maintains the ever-widening gap. Ill-gotten money from ill-gotten gains. Gains are now classed as criminal, but money that stays in their pockets forever, all the way down to little Torah.
She wasn't like that.
I think you're missing the point. The money she gave you was like that. So who kept real wealth? Your labour.
You lost me.
Marx says that the money created in the labour of the workers should be owned by the workers.
So the profit?
The capital.
The labour of the firm.
That's it. The labour in your phone.
$5 a phone, and I've made 700 phones a day.
So it's sold for $500.
man who shot me, so no one take on the case because they're too afraid. How can you charge for rainwater? How can you own rainwater? Doesn't rainwater belong to God?
It's like charging for sky, or air, or the view.
Exactly. And to the likes of Torah just getting richer and richer.
But she was so nice to animals.
And it's not questionable.
Because it's always been and always will be. No, it hasn't always been. That's another myth. The way we consume the endless more is new.
We just went along with it.
Yeah. Or didn't see the end point.
Didn't see the assembly lines. Companies that don't care about human rights don't care about the planet or anything.
That's right, Joy.
Oh, get a grip! What does this mean to us now we're here?
So not caring about the masses is fine once you're in heaven.
That's not what I meant. The music stays the same.
Then it's time to take action.
Action?
Now you're talking, bro.
Whose side are you on, Hoffnail?
Sides. Yeah. Are they sides? Yeah. Organised.
Trocking.
Yeah. Trocking. The dancing is to keep the world in motion. That right?
Yes.
What if we refuse to dance?
What? You can't do that.
No, you can't. Can't we?
Can we?
We can.
Right. What are you trying to do to me?
It's nothing personal.
How is it not personal?
It's called collective bargaining.
What's that?
If you stop dancing, everything will just stop. It's all we have to negotiate with.
The peach should be perfect.
Exactly.
I don't like Toto.
It's not about Toto, Shway.
Did you talk to him, Pop?
Yeah, she's furious.
Furious, bro?
Yes, furious, bro. She's sending someone.
Who?
Who's that?
Switch, Bosh, Bash!
Hi, Mike! What's up?
It's Mike! It's the Archangel Michael to you lot.
He's always like, well hungry. Bye, Mike!
The Archangel Michael!
Not anymore, Lemuel. I've been promoted. I'm a seraph now. Top dog. Swish, Bosh, Bash!
Oh, we're very honoured.
Ow! No! Is that the end of a chicken burger?
Yeah.
Fed on cheap soy feed from a cleared Amazon rainforest, bred in tiny cages with their beaks chopped off so they don't peck at each other to death.
Don't you ever switch off?
No.
It's imagined. Well, someone else imagined it for me. There are more and more vegans in heaven, so it's a bit disappointing taste for us.
You got anything else?
No.
Head massage?
I'd be honest, your greatness.
Your greatness.
Please stay relaxed.
And what are you? Middle management?
No, I'm a seraphim. One tier down from God. Hey, I got promoted. Is no one listening?
You don't think there's a problem with the hierarchy?
Everyone's happy.
Not everyone.
They like some Toto, bruv.
Who are Toto?
They're an American rock band from the 80s.
Oh, yeah, I got you. Rosanna, Africa, hold the line.
Yeah, but it's more than that. Actually, I've got a list of demands.
Too long? Whoa!
We would like consensus, discussion, and everything voted on. We'd like to choose when we meet God, and we want to return. Oh, and then there's Toto.
No one gets to speak to them.
Why not?
You're not even angels.
Yeah, you're not!
So?
So?
That's the whole point of our hierarchy.
What? So, we're not equal.
Heaven is not concerned with equality.
Well, then how is it holy? It can't be if you're saying that you have access and I can't. You can make decisions about our time here and I can't. You can choose and we're ready to return and I can't. I have no power, no say, no authority.
I can't believe you didn't get me a feast.
What?
There is one, isn't there? Just tucked around the corner.
No! This is because you believe you are better than me. Better than all of us. We are lesser than you, and through this logic, you decide what is best for us. That is the definition of fascism.
Yeah, you're a fascist.
A fascist?
You can't say that!
No, you can't call him that!
I'm a seraphim! An angel of first tier! Part of the heavenly hierarchy! You can't call me a fascist!
You're all fascists!
No, we're angels!
Yeah, we didn't make the rules! No, we didn't! We're not responsible!
Well, then we'd like to speak to who is, because it's time for a regime change.
What?!
I'm some Toto.
We demand to speak to God, or we'll stop dancing.
That's it! personally ruined my life.
But I haven't done that, have I?
You have!
You're dead already.
Woman, hair. Always, always be dry!
Why is he so upset?
And split ends, just loads of them!
He wants to be an angel. Yeah, you're part of the hierarchy. The first premise of heaven should be equality.
Then be careful about the authority, without the rule.
Ah!
started them.
I was murdered.
Well, that's always happening.
Collecting rainwater.
Deregulating markets and an unsafe environment. Exploitation without union protection. So fossil fuel, land, air, energy. Society fragmented, communities devastated. Companies took their businesses to the cheapest, which left a tiny minority at the top, just getting richer and more powerful. That's what happened while you were sleeping.
And people suffered?
Terribly.
Why didn't you wake me?
I didn't think there was anything you could do about it. You had such a bad cold. Anyway, they're always going bad people.
But not on a global scale. Not within a world order from which no one can escape from, in which cruelty is justified in the name of financial gain. That is new. You need to step down. Show a different way forward. You weren't even awake.
No. He's been ill.
Oh, a cold that lasts 5 decades.
I still don't understand why you didn't wake me.
Like I said, your cold was terrible.
And you like the power loop.
I did not like the power.
You did?
I didn't.
You did.
Right. You did. That's why he didn't tell us.
It wasn't like that.
Dude.
It was.
The rules, the authority, have to change. There'll be chaos anyway, unless the world is reimagined. You should step down. Let us decide. You're a dictator.
I don't really see myself as a dictator.
Well, what else are you?
Well, I'm good, aren't I?
Yes,
I
yes.
Always thought of myself as good.
Yeah.
Well, if your dictator is utterly good and eternal, I don't really see the problem.
Without everyone taking responsibility, there can be no change. And once we return, we'll go back to the order, the rules, the authority, the system.
I've never thought of any of it like that. A dictator, really.
But it has always been this way.
And it has led us to here, to the end of everything. True freedom is only possible if we all take responsibility, and it's only then that the real change can happen.
Well, I guess we'll try for a bit. It may help my cold clear up.
You can't ask that! With the sound of my fingers, I can send you back a letter to this murderous war! Or I can give you an immediate letter and think there's any disease out there, and you die horribly! A malaria, typhoons, Ebola, coronavirus, or I'd like to piss me cannot breathe when I stop in every corner and where.
What are you saying?
I just she's disrespectful.
And you won't?
And she's in your appointment. You should step down. Let us decide.
Well, I guess we could try for a bit. It may help my cold clear up.
You can't step down.
Why ever not? I'm good. I can do anything.
imagine that it can be.
You can imagine that you were a revolutionary leader.
No, I didn't imagine that. I am that.
But you had to imagine a different system before it could change.
Yeah.
So it's the system itself that makes us think we can't change anything, but you change the order, you change the system, you change the people.
You were listening.
I'm an angel!
Are you sure you don't want to come with us, Muriel?
No, thank you. It's Cindy, huh?
Cindy.
It's Cindy's brother.
So, like, the revolution would work here in big, big blood. Or the world heart, because it's bad when the sisters being as it's got Cindy.
For many, the world is Cindy.
Capitalism.
A gold. Their gold.
He's an awesome revolutionary, wouldn't it, bro?
Peace at last, the banner bright, the symbol plain of human rights.
this year at the National Theatre Connections, we've had lots of different versions, but as far as I know, you are the only company who have made a film and a live play, which I think is pretty impressive. So I went and met this company about a month ago, and they were rehearsing for a film that you saw little bits of. And then to take that as an idea and totally reconceptualise it again and make an amazing live version is such an achievement, especially in 2020 and 2021. So we're going to talk a little bit about the creation of this show and go back to that first point like we did with the Rep Project earlier on, about the first book where you read it. And this is a complicated place. It has lots of Marxism, obviously, built into it all the way through. So I'm really interested in finding out from some of you, when you first read that play, what did you think? And how did that get us to where we are today? Hello.
Hello. Hi. When I first got the script, we had it on a computer, like Word document. And when I started reading through it, I had no idea what was going on. I had no idea what a Marxist was. I didn't know anything. And so the first few lessons were on Zoom, and we basically just spent about like 2 hours just trying to explain what Marxist is.
Over Zoom.
Yeah, what everything is.
Everyone's favourite Zoom session. When was that? Can you remember?
Long time.
Oh, was it? Yeah. February. Okay.
Also a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think what helped us the most was we had a talk with the author, and that gave us a lot of information about the play. So
great.
We knew what was going on.
And how did that go? So tell me something that you took away from that were really key.
She was talking, obviously, Marxist, because none of us knew what that was. She was talking about how they're not unallowed in heaven, and there's a hierarchy, and Valerie, the character, wants equality everywhere. And the hierarchy, there's cherubim, seraphim, you've got the god, and then you've got multitudes, and I don't know any of it. So there's an order, but Annie wants everyone to be equal.
Annie. Not even the character, just Annie.
I also learnt that Bob was her favourite character, just saying. Yeah.
So what was it like when you were first doing all of that art and soup? Yeah, no, thank you.
It was weird, it was hard, there were a lot of technical issues. When Michelle was trying to tell us what Marxism is, we're hearing like construction noises and weird sounds, but we got it eventually.
Where were you zooming from, Michelle? Building stuff.
You're my mom.
we eventually got it, I think. Most of us got it, I think.
Okay, so how did you get then from that Zoom to that intensive week in rehearsals in the church where I came and met you? Someone I've not heard of.
It was a massive change, because obviously I hadn't actually met most of this cast. So it was nice meeting everyone. But it was like weird because we had to put in our heads what we thought the system of heaven was into a church where we were going to be filming it, and where, I don't know, it was just crazy because it was so different. It was difficult and intense that whole week of just rehearsals, but it was fun, and I've learned a lot from this play.
Yeah.
Nothing I could really think of.
The things that have constantly blown my mind with all of the companies this year is the sort of determination to make work against the odds. So what Mishmak had was, how long did you have the church for, Michelle? It was 1 week, wasn't it?
Yeah, so we did Monday to Friday, and then we filmed it on the Saturday.
That's right, yeah, and to film it all in one day, basically you created a promenade performance that happened in the main altar space of the church, but also the kind of the room at the back, the community room at the back, and then as you saw, all the way around the grounds as well. A really complicated performance, and then it made into a really nice film. And then what bits did you take from that, and what bits did you leave behind when trying to then reimagine it again for the stage? I'm going to go to someone I have not spoken to. Hello.
So I think turning it into a film was quite difficult, and then to reverse it back
And you've got moments like your little magic tricks that obviously on the film you need to do a kind of fun cut and here you have to find ways around it, but I think you did a really good job. Someone else talked to me about reimagining it again. Hello.
Well, like, what, it was really hard for, well, I know a lot of people in this play that had, like, blocking that they remember really well in their head and then they just had to forget that.
Yeah.
And learn a whole different new blocking, that bit. I bet it was just so hard.
Yeah. Just reimagining the whole thing. Yeah. Anyone else? Go on.
I think it was quite hard because if you just learn a piece of blocking and then today I don't want to say this, but I didn't. Sometimes I was a bit confused about where to go, but I think it still will work down quite good.
Yeah. I bumped into someone backstage who said, I think everyone's on stage, but I was on the toilet. But you would never know. It's an amazing achievement trying to pull it together. And I'm so proud of the way that you, Michelle, have taken that ambition. I think lots of people would have settled to just do one of those either way and to have tried to put it together. You would have learned so much from this process. We've got about 6 minutes. I'd love to take some questions from the audience about bits that they liked, either whether that's the play, or the staging, or the characters. Hello there.
Hello. I don't have a question, I just have something to say. Congratulations, that was amazing. I watched your film a few weeks ago when Michelle sent it, and which was brilliant on its own. But this, you are all so joyful to watch, and I know that the script is quite serious, and you're exploring quite serious issues, but actually, all of your energy is so infectious, and I just found myself smiling the entire time.
Yeah,
so
me too.
Thank you so much for that.
Yeah.
Such a pleasure to watch. I don't really have a question other than what you were just talking about, having to re-block stuff. I think that would be really confusing for adult professionals, let alone kind of you, like a young company with a limited amount of rehearsal time. So I think you've just done the most amazing job, so you should all be so proud of yourself. That's what I don't have a question.
You've got the most brilliant energy. Where's the mighty mess?
Yeah.
I could hear every word, even when you were at the very back of the balcony.
Yeah.
It was electric just watching you perform. And there are companies that do that role who are sort of like, how old are you?
10.
Companies who do that who are like 8 or 9 years older than you, who don't have the energy that you do. It was really brilliant. It was a fantastic performance. Some questions?
But just to say this, we lost a lot of our GCSE and A-level students. Mishmak normally does in Connections every year. This is the youngest cast I've done Connections with on the hardest year.
Yeah.
So our youngest cast member is 8.
Yeah.
And our oldest is 14 or 15.
I think it might be the youngest cast I've ever done.
So,
it's an amazing achievement. Hello.
About the age, how did like the younger people, how do you feel doing like a play that talks about such political things? I know you might not know what it's talking about, but how did it feel taking on such a, not hard role, but you know.
My semester.
I think at the beginning, I was just in my bed, in the kitchen, just like listening, and then my mum was going on about all this Marxism, and I was just like, and she was like, has anyone got any questions? And I was just like,
yeah,
about 100. And then she was just like, okay, sorry, someone can ask me questions, and I was just like.
Well, Zoom calls went on for 2 hours.
Yeah.
But I think you've done an amazing job of making it quite comprehensible for these very dense play. Other thoughts? People are here.
Oh, don't look
at us. Was that the whole play or was it cut down?
There's a question in
there. That's
us. Over here, who is that?
Ash.
No,
Oh, sorry.
How many times have we whacked each other with the wings?
Plenty.
Oh no, yeah. My enemy is doorways. Trying to get through backstage.
Yeah. I was backstage putting the wings on and I knocked the firecrackers off with the wings.
Yeah, it was me.
2 minutes.
Talk later, darling.
Go on.
Oh, it was just more of a thought. I really liked the use of, because you match the physical, how high you were, with the actual hierarchy of the people. I thought that was really clever. Like, even with the I might get the terminology wrong, even with the angels and then the bigger angels on the top of the table. It's more of a comment, I thought it was really clever how it matched.
Yeah, it's a lovely use of balcony, which I know when I first met you, you were like, there's a balcony, we're going to use the balcony. And I thought you built it in really well and actually made some of that magic and the jokes of running around still really funny. Go on, last question.
How did you go up the stairs so far?
We have to cut a few things because of the stairs. So like at the beginning, I kind of gave Bob a look. At first I was meant to run up, but they could hear me. So we had to cut that. But I don't know how Ronnie did it. I don't know how Annie did it, but they did it.
About the going up the stairs question, I went up the stairs and I was on the top step and I had to fall on the last step.
In the performance?
Yeah.
But are you okay?
Yeah. Just about 2 steps.
So it's just the energy of you that we can only dream of. Can we give them another few?